What's going on, guys? 370 Gaming here, and we're finally back after a little hiatus, you know, maybe like 1 week. But hey, this is episode 9, Local to Global series. That's right, TEW 2013, back where it always should be. And you know, sorry to leave you guys waiting for a while. I've had a very busy couple weeks here, and actually, I'm getting this done last minute too. I'm recording this on like Sunday night of the week. You know, I like to get these up usually like Saturday morning, you know, record them on Friday or Saturday, but yeah, man, hey, better late than never, right? You know, so that's my saying. That's what I always say. I don't know where I'm going with this. Anyways, so we got the next episode here. As you could see, last week, last 2 weeks, last month in game, something like that, we made a lot of money. Made a lot of money. Look at that. $6,353 profit. Probably the most money I've made in 1 month, unless you go back and check the tapes and see that I actually did make more money 1 month. I don't know. Maybe I did. But anyways, so it's been quite a while for me. I don't really remember what we were doing, because that's what happens when you don't play the game. But I like that I have this series, because it forces me to kind of get up and go back to the game, and I really do love this fucking game. Game's great, man. Love this game. And so it's cool that, you know, it's kind of a quote-unquote excuse to go back to it. Especially I've been playing, like, 2K16 a lot, or, you know, just, well, mostly I've been doing work, but, you know, that's a whole different topic. So let's go to what was the last show, Over the Moon. Got an E-minus rating there. Ah, 10% real Juice Robinson, that's right. He challenged Kindred. Kindred declined, said if he won his match that he would get a title shot. So I suppose that's the main event for the next show, is Juice Robinson versus Kindred. What a match that will be. Adam Cole and Cage keeping their momentum up, because why not? Why not indeed? Johnny Cockstrong imitating Kafu, and Juice Robinson defeated Kafu. Oh man, Kafu had a bad day that day. But that's fine, because if you guys will recall, in the last video, the last TEW video, I had you guys think of who could be Kafu's Lana. If Kafu is Rusev, who is the Lana to Kafu? And you guys gave me perfect examples. And people that I really should have thought of, you know, in the first place. But, the final two I'm thinking of is either SoCal Val or Veda Scott. I like Veda Scott a lot. She's definitely one of my favorites out there right now. So we're probably gonna go see what she's up to. So that's definitely gonna be something we do today. As well as I'd like to pursue the Insane Clown Posse. For number one, we gotta wrap up that story with TEW Dope, you know, his fucking audition tapes. You know, is he gonna tell him, are they gonna tell him, yeah, you're good to go, you could join us, or are they gonna, you know, beat the shit out of him, because, you know, they're clown assholes, you know what I mean? What's gonna happen there? You never know. But also, if I can bring them in as faces, depending on what they're good at, I'd like to have them be part of the tag team division for now. Kind of build it around Castle and Creed, and depending on Adam Cole and Cage, depending on how that turns out, we might pursue that option further as well. But that's two heel teams, so I can't just base that around, you know, gotta have a fucking face team, you know, what are you gonna do? So Juice Robinson earns his title shot at the next show. I don't even know what the name of the next show is going to be, by the way. I have, like, nothing planned today. That's why we're doing this fucking recap video here. Marcus Owens hype video, and Kindred and Castle and Creed defeated ACH and Marcus Crane and TEW Dope. Okay, solid show. Wasn't the greatest received, that show. So, I'm trying to think. I wanted Kindred to be, like, the man. You know what I'm saying? I wanted him and Truth Martini to just fucking skyrocket popularity. People playing music outside my window, can you not, please? Thank you. And what I'm trying to figure out is how good is Juice Robinson? That's what I'm trying to figure out. Weak, average, I'm trying to see here, reputation, respect is abysmal, oh gosh. Abysmal, yeah. So, they look about the same, other than the fact that, actually, Kindred's better in the ring. So, Kindred's only real flaw is that he just gets gassed in, like, fucking 15-minute matches, dude. I think Juice Robinson could probably go 15 minutes. That's all I'm saying. That's all I'm saying, man. And, yeah, so, eh, you know? I mean, it's hard, man. You're trying to build a company over somebody, around somebody. And, not that I thought Kindred was going to be the next fucking John Cena or something, but I, you know, I'd like to give him a few months with the title, you know what I'm saying? But we'll work on that. So that is to be determined here. Let's say I do one show again this month, because last month that, oh my god, that $6,000 profit, that really made me happy. So we could save some money, run one show. Trying to think here. Okay, so let's just run one show. As for the name, so we had Go Dog Go, Up Up and Away, Over the Moon. I don't know. My brain doesn't feel like it works to make anything funny right now. Well, what kind of name suggestions do we got? I can't fuck this up because it's auto-generated, so you can't blame me if it's misspelled. Wrestling Spirit, Into the Void. I kind of like Into the Void, because I'm not, generally I don't go off the second one, but Over the Moon, Into the Void, I don't know. Does that make any sense? We'll think about that. Welcome to the Party? Oh, that's fucking awesome. That's a great name. Yeah, I'm going to use that later. Let me write that down. Welcome to the Party. What a great fucking name. That's amazing. All right. Manifest Destiny. Where Eagles Dare. What the hell? In Times of War. No, that's when we start a fucking Ring of Honor invasion storyline. Balls to the Wall. That's another solid name. Balls to the Wall is pretty good. Let's do Balls to the Wall. I'm going with that. I want to keep Into the Void as an option as well. Into the Void, Welcome to the Party. And Balls to the fucking Wall, dude. Yeah, doesn't get much better than that. Alright, TTW. I gotta... You know, someday soon I'll have custom logos again, guys. It kind of depresses me just having the same logo, but eh. Okay, so if we do one show... I mean, I'm going to have to do a lot of simulating regardless. But, really quick, let me see this here. So, like, let's say we do... We ran week 3 before, is that right? Let me just do that really quick. I believe we ran week 3. Yeah, Friday week 3. In keeping with that theme, I'd like to, like, you know, just be like, oh, we did well last month, how about this month? Like, something like that. But, I'm trying to see if the week that it's scheduled has any effect on the attendance, you know what I mean? So what was, like, the lowest attendance we got? 31, it looks like. That was week 2. That was week 2. So week 2 seems to... Well, no, I guess that one just blew that out of the water. That was Friday. That was Sunday. That was also Friday. Okay, so there's no patterns. I thought there was going to be, like, some patterns we could exploit. I guess not. So we'll stick with the week 3. We'll see how that goes. Got 18 days to plan a show that I don't have any plans for yet. Yeah. So, you know, we got some things to do. We got Veda Scott, we got the Insane Clown Posse. Also, I have a great name for this guy. I was watching some shows on the TV, and got a good name for him. You'll see about that later. But, oh yeah, the Bravados. How much are they worth? 300. Yeah, see, when you're recording everything, guys, this is what happens. There's a lot of thinking about stuff, you know what I mean? A lot of pre-planning here. So he was, oh my god, what was he, like 600? Holy shit. Shaggy? 4-9, that's better. Can't you actually work, like, compared to Violent J? 40, 40, 30, 31. No, I guess not. Microphone, any difference? No. No difference in resilience. Violent J has slightly more charisma. From the little, like, actual wrestling I ever saw them do, I always thought Shaggy could work, like, better than Violent J, but I guess... Eh. It's not really that big of a difference. I really should take Linda and JR off of here. I always want to know if something happens to JR, man. We gotta keep that fucking storyline going. And then, what is it? Ricochet, he's $1 million. Oh, what? Oh, you fucking egotistical piece of shit. Oh my god, okay. Mr. Big Head over here doesn't want to fucking sign with TTW. Well, you know what? Fuck you, Ricochet. Fuck you. Mr. Big-headed fucking asshole. Johnny Gargano. We'll push Johnny Gargano to the fucking moon. Fuck Ricochet. Fuck him. Alright. So, I'm thinking Bravado's over this clown posse deal here. Because I could get both of the Bravado's for the price of Violent J. Is that not right? $250 and... Yeah. So for $550, I could get both the Bravados, and he's fucking $620. They're not worth it. You're not worth it. How popular are you? E-minus? E-minus? That is better. I'll give them that. I'll give them that. They are more popular than the Bravados. That's fair. That's a fair observation there. That's a hard one. We're gonna have to think about that one. How about Veda? What's she doing? $230. That is very much worth it. Yeah, I could fuck with that. Let's do a year. I know, I ended up signing so many people to fucking 3-year contracts like I'm fucking WWE, you know, sign with me for 10 years, you know, because we're never going to let go of you. Like, no, that's fucking creepy. who else is she working with? ROH, AIW, 2CW, Shimmer. Okay. Nothing threatening as of this moment. So that's cool. So, yeah, everything looks kosher. Alright. So, yeah, I just like Veda Scott. She's a really good personality. She's really cool. And I think she can work. Can she work in the ring? I don't know. Average. She claims to be average. I haven't seen her, like, in too many matches. I've seen her in, like, Ring of Honor, Women of Honor matches, but those are very few and far between. And, you know, I suppose I should make an attempt to watch more. In Shine, isn't she also or am I thinking of fucking SoCal Val again? Thinking of SoCal Val. Yeah. Okay. A lot of you don't even know what I'm talking about. That's alright. Moving on. Veda Scott is, is the Lana to Kafu. So that's gonna be excellent pairing. Excellent pairing. Okay. So I think we're going to hold off a few days for either the Juggalos or the Bravados. If we made the $6,000 every month, we could hire all of them, theoretically. But, I feel so cheap and stingy. I feel cheap and stingy, not trying to spend all my fucking money. What about that one guy that, him. $240. Yeah, you're, like, worth, like, nothing. Like, it's no big deal. I think we got enough guys that we're trying to, like, build from the floor. Like, you know? Like, we gotta put our efforts towards, you know, these guys. You know what I'm saying? But, yeah. So, I think I have a better idea now of what's going on, what we're doing. So, let's advance a few days only, just in case something happens, and perhaps I want to see... obviously it's gonna stop when Veda wants to talk to us, but, like, for example, if it's loading and I'm thinking to myself, oh, gee, wouldn't it be good if we got such and such, then yeah, then let me do that. So, let's advance 5 days, and we'll see what happens. Alrighty, we're back here, got that done. Anything fancy happening over here? Nope, not too much. Anybody want to see the SmackDown report? Huh? Anybody? Huh? You, with the hand, putting your hand up, yeah? You want to see it? Alright, let's see SmackDown. Let's check it out. What we got here? Rollins defeated Ambrose and Wyatt to retain... Holy shit. What a main event that was for SmackDown, man. No wonder they drew 11,000 people. Oh my god. Oh boy. Rusev and Ziggler, Alicia Fox and Naomi, Cena and The Big Show, of course. Owens defeated Bo Dallas, Adam Rose, and why is that not coming to me? Young. Oh my god, who's Young? Why? Darren Young? Good god! Oh my god, you guys. Wow. Okay. Undertaker and Seth Rollins. Miz and Zayn. Brock Oh, shit. Okay. Alright. Solomon Crowe. Gotta eat shit with Roman Reigns. Sheamus and Tyler Breeze. That's a fucking team right there. That is a team. I don't know what kind of team, but that's a team, alright. Anyways, I was thinking, guys, when I come back from, like, long loading times, what would you think if, like, we went through the news archive and just looked? Like, I feel like I'm gonna miss something, like, when we just fucking, like, speed through real hard. Obviously, okay, as I recall, we went through Hell in a Cell. We looked at that, because that was right after the month. So, TWB from development. So, I don't know, for example, like, what if they fire somebody and I don't have them, like, on tap on, like, shortlist? Like, I don't know, that would bum me out. Not that I could, like, sign anybody or something. Like, when I'm bigger, then I should do it. But, I don't know. I always feel like I'm gonna miss something, you know? People have entered the wrestling world. That's cool. And shows were ran. Okay. So, obviously, this was 5 days. It wasn't that much. But you understand what I'm saying. Yeah. Okay. Veda Scott. You beautiful, beautiful woman. Let's get this rolling. Kung Fu is a heel, correct? Is that right? Anybody? Double check that for me? Yeah, pretty sure that's right. Complete contract. Sweet. Alright, for now you're going to be a manager. For now. No, you're not going to be an authority. Although, that's not a bad idea, to be honest. That's not the worst idea. I've heard worse ideas than her being an authority figure. But for now, you're a manager. So, I hope she doesn't get all fucking pissed off about that. I'm going to be in the authority figure. Ugh. Like, no. You do what I tell you to. Oh, wow. Okay. That's... Yeah. That's an alternative picture. You know, hey, I mean, as attractive as that is, eh. I'm just trying to look for something more managerial. But, yeah. So that's fine. That'll be fine. So that's cool. You're gonna manage my boy Kafu over here. He needs some help in the, promo department, I'm pretty sure. And as soon as I get my wits about me, we're gonna give him the manager. Boom. That's how you do it. That's how you play this game. Okay. So, let's say we make that amount of money. We're not going to make that amount of money next month, probably. But if we did, Veda Scott was now, what was she, like 230? Okay, 230. So, we could hire... I want to hire the Bravados and, like, build my tag division around them. But I also want to... I also, just to be funny, because this game, you know, it's fun. I want to have, you know, the clowns. You know what I mean? I want to have the clowns. Let's... How's the in-ring of the Bravados? Are they, like, really good? Or average? You're not giving me much to work with, guys. Come on. Come on, guys. Yeah, I would love, like, if we're looking at Shaggy Tito, if his chain wrestling was, like, a fucking A-minus or something. Like, whoa, dude! Either this game is way off, or Shaggy went into training. What the fuck? What I might do is... Oh, boy. That's hard. That's really hard. How much are they worth again? Violent J is 620, and Shaggy is 490. Oh, fuck. That's gonna be over 1,000 a month. I say we gotta wait one more video to see how much money we make. Because if we can pull in $6,000 a month, I have no problem hiring the Insane Clown Posse. But if we can't, then I'm very hesitant to. I think I want to hire the Bravados. I think I want to hire them. Because I think I need to have that tag division going. Do I have anybody working on Evolve right now? When does Evolve run their shows? Can I look at that? I'm sorry, you guys. I'm all over the place right now. My mind is just, like, racing. We gotta look at this here. I don't know if they're... Okay. every Saturday. That doesn't... I do Friday and Sunday, so that doesn't bother me. Oh, we got WWN Live iPay-per-view. Well, fuck you. Where's my iPay-per-view, man? I could try to join the World Wrestling Network. Can you do that? Can I try to join that? Is that a thing? An alliance? Can I join? I think that's what everybody was telling me to do, join one of the alliances and shit. I might end up doing that. If... I don't know. As I've stated before on this series, I don't really want to do that. Just because it doesn't feel like you worked as hard to get where you are. You know what I mean? It feels like you just kind of cheated, more or less. I know it's not cheating, but it feels like it. And, you know, like, if Ring of Honor had, like, an alliance, like, they're not... Yeah, they're not in the Global Force or anything. They're not in this. They're not in there. So, like, my roster, the closest thing would be Ring of Honor people. But, oh, by the way, heel, okay. What am I trying to say? If Ring of Honor had, like, an alliance thing, I'd be more willing to join them down the line, because I share a lot of, like, roster members, but... You know, I mean, if I pick up more Evolve people down the line, and it's not like the World Wrestling Network is like some ridiculous fucking alliance that's just gonna skyrocket me up to the fucking top of everything. I mean, they, you know, they got their own thing going on, to be honest, so. We might do that. Maybe I'll wait till I get past local, and then I'll join them. Like, kinda, like, you gotta earn your stripes. Somebody's probably watching this video right now and they're like, dude, you can't join an alliance until you're at least, like, small. Like, what are you talking about? And then I'll, you know, I look stupid, but, you know, it's not the first time I look stupid, and it's not the last time I'm gonna look stupid either. See, when you look stupid, you gotta own it. You know what I mean? You gotta say, hey, man, I'm stupid, you know? You gotta be like fucking Eminem in the fucking 8 Mile movie, where he's like, yeah, I'm white, and I'm this, and I'm that, and blah, blah, blah. And see, once you shit on yourself enough, you understand, it goes all around, you know what I mean? But this is a lot of talking, and you know, I'm boring you guys, so I'm sorry about that. We're gonna move on here. So, my bad. Bravados. Gotta get the Bravados here. Harlem Bravado. You guys are gonna be my tag team division. For now. Until, you know, I don't know, we get the Young Bucks. Until we get the Young Bucks. Then maybe we'll do, what are you, 300? How much was Harlem? 250? And then I brought it down to like 200 or 230 or something. Let's try to get the downside to, oh, I can take him off. I got you already, Juice, baby. Try to get you down to 250 downside. 240? That's ballsy. I don't know. Let's see. Can we go even lower? How low will you take your downside, bruh? Okay. Okay. 220? Sure. Sounds good to me. Okay. Alright, so we got something cooking there. I'd like to bring them in as a face, like, happy-go-lucky tag team. To combat Cage and Adam Cole and Creed and Castle. Yeah, that would be my plan. So, they're not too expensive. Even if we don't get so much money, it won't be such a horrible, horrible blow to my company here. And, yeah, sorry guys, I'm just, like, blathering on and shit. Like I said, I haven't played this game in a long time, and I have to just get an idea of what's going on again. This game is so much fun. If you guys don't have this game, you just like the idea of it, I mean, I definitely recommend it. It's kind of a pain in the ass, because you get the license, and then, like, you have to... If you get a new computer, you have to go through so many hoops to, like, get it back on there. But, I mean, if you got your computer and you're set, and you want to get this game, I fucking absolutely recommend it. This game's awesome. 16 days, let's go 6 days. And we will see what happens. Alright, we're back here, and I saw something interesting. Ah, contract extension, damn. Not that Wade Barrett or Sami Zayn or Sheamus were really gonna, like, hop on board, but... Hey, you gotta keep your eyes open, you know what I'm saying? Delirious re-signing, that seems likely. Yeah, seems likely. Okay, anything else? No? Okay. Got some emails and some decisions. Bravados. Welcome aboard, gentlemen. Yeah, no, oh, that's another thing. I forgot to check Veda Scott's mic skills. Maybe, like, SoCal Val would have been better. I should have probably checked that, but I just like Veda Scott, so, I mean, it doesn't really bother me. doesn't really bother me. I wanted to see how they do. Okay, they're strong. Strong faces. Good, 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 good. Okay, so you guys are going to be my face tag team. That's what it's about. Complete that contract. We'll complete your contract. And what do we got here? Brandon Watts, released by CCW. Don't worry, Brandon Watts. I will never fire you. I will never fire you. You are welcome here, my friend. Push. Kind of push mid-carder. Cool, cool. Good. This is good. I like these signings. This was a good set of signings here. Oh. Oh, Lance getting a little big for his too big for his partner there, huh? Okay. Oh, that reminds me, by the way. I wanted to see how much the Young Bucks were. I'm pretty sure I looked at this already, but let me just see. Oh, that, okay, that was the case. That makes sense. I'm not really surprised, but, you will be ours eventually, gentlemen. You will be mine. You will be mine. Yeah, not ours. You'll be mine. I will own you. I will own you and your families. You will depend on me. And, yeah, I will sound less sadistic in the future, so we'll work on that. Teams. Teams would be good. I'm gonna add a team. I said we're gonna add a team. Hello? There we go. Okay. Alright. Harlem Bravado and Lance Bravado. I'm pretty sure they were just called the Bravado Brothers. Am I wrong about that? Oh. What? The Bravado Brothers, yeah. That's what I thought. Okay. Cool. Cool, 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 cool. Good shit. Good shit. Do they have a finish? Give me one sec. I'm gonna go check if they have a finish. Alright. So, I checked Wikipedia, and I gotta admit, I took a little break, and I was watching some sweet old, like, Dragon Gate USA clips. Aw, man. The vibe of those shows just seems so cool to me. The more I really wanted TTW to kind of join WWN, we might end up doing that. But their finisher is supposedly a assisted whiplash, and they call it the Gentleman's Agreement. Yeah, I've not seen too many, you know, Bravado Brothers matches. I've seen them mostly, like, as jobbers in Ring of Honor, and I've seen one or two here and there. I watched the match with Bad Influence, when Bad Influence just got off, TNA. You know, they did that, I don't know if any of you know this, they got them to agree to go to a Dragon Gate USA show, but they couldn't be shown on iPay-per-view yet, so they had them do just a dark match for the crowd. And then they eventually released the footage on a... Was it on DVD? It's on YouTube now. Either way. Gentleman's Agreement. That's the finisher. So there's that. Yeah. Yeah, you know. I try to provide you guys with some info. You know what I mean? Some back... Not necessarily backstory, but, you know, some context, man. Don't you want context to your show? No? You just want to watch me book the show? I understand. Anyways! Let's go... Oh, man, I don't want to wait, like, 5 hours for this to load. Fuck. Okay, I guess we got to. Should we go a week? See what's going on in a week? See if anything changes? Let's go a week. Alright, we're back here. Week's up, finally. Or something has happened, either way. Looks like Nigel McGuinness is re-signing. Thank God for that. We need more Nigel McGuinness in our lives. Veda Scott, apparently, going to re-sign with somebody else as well. Do whatever you want, as long as you don't leave me. Yeah, that's fine. I'm not bothered by that. Just don't fucking try to bail on my contract, okay? Everything's fine. Oh, speaking of which, did any of the new contract people not, like, do they not gel with my schedule here? Friday? Nope, we're good. We are good to go. We got 1 week left. So let's go ahead and go to that week, because, yeah, I got nothing left to do, you know? We'll hire the Insane Clown Posse next video if I don't lose too much money. Yeah, I mean, well, if I lose money at all. If I'm negative, there's no fucking way I'm going to hire them. But if I have anywhere around that, I'm not going to lie, probably going to hire them. I really want that storyline to come to fruition. But yeah, let's go that week, and we will see what happens. Alright guys, we're back here. Got some unread emails. Oh, actually didn't want to do that. Yeah, I just wanted to see here. Lich Underground, I guess, is keeping. That's cool. And, yeah, I wanted to check the news archive. Just because it looked like... Yeah! What the fuck? Yo, the Undertaker just fucking left. Yeah, I didn't think so. That's crazy. What the hell? Because I saw some stuff about John Laurinaitis, I saw some stuff about The Undertaker, I didn't know what the fuck was going on. Wow. That's a big development right there. Do we want to shortlist him and see where he goes? Is anybody else interested in that? He's number one in the Power 500, guys. What the hell? That's crazy. That is fucking crazy, man. American Independent Show. An independent show was held last night in Mid-South Gymnasium. What the hell is this? Just a random independent show? Promotion. Independent show. What the hell? I thought I was an independent show. Like, what the fuck? Huh. Alright. Okay. So anything else going on? Cody Hall extended his deal. Yeah. Because, you know, when you when the loading screens are going by, it says X amount of people are doing, you know, contract extensions, and I like to just keep... Oh, so they'll sign Kane, but they won't sign The Undertaker. I see how it is. I see how it is. Poor Undertaker, man. That's terrible. That's terrible. I'm sure he can find some work. I'm sure he can find some work. Veda Scott extended her deal. That's good. Good for her. Good for her. Tonight is TTW Balls to the Wall. Thank God, because I feel like I've been talking for, like, I don't know how long I've been recording, but I feel like I've been talking for most of it, and most of it's not been that amusing. If you've been entertained... then I've done my job. However, if I've not, then, you know, then we got some problems, man. Don't fucking come to my house with fucking pitchforks and torches, man. I tried. I did my best. I did my best. Harlan Bravado is related to Lance Bravado. That is true. That is a very true point. I wonder if that helped at all with the backstage rating. I hope so. Actually, that's a good point. I wonder if they're, like, happy because they signed the other one. Very happy and pleased. So I guess I signed him second. And I signed him first, because he's, like, stoked to, like, yeah. Well, that's great. I'm glad everybody's so happy. Okay. How many people are we getting? 75 people would be... Oh. 66. Fuck. Ah! I hate reading things wrong. Oh, boy. How many years are we gonna have to run until we... until we fucking... Oh, my God. What do we have to do? I forgot at this point. What do we have to do? Small. F+. We just have to get to F+. What do we have to do? Do I have to put on, like, a fucking WrestleMania size show? Probably, like I said, I probably just gotta keep running shows, and that probably takes quite a while. And I'm an impatient man, so I'd really like it if they could hurry the fuck up here, you know? Hurry the fuck up. Let's save. Let's go to the show! The meat and potatoes of this fucking show! Alright. Of my YouTube show. Not this show. The show is its own show. You understand what I'm saying. Anyways, let's book the main event. Because, fuck it. Why would we not? Do a standard singles match. I'm fucked up. Okay. World title. Kindred, my boy. He can't go very long. Let's do 16 minutes, maybe. I think he's still going to get gassed at that point. Juice Robinson and Kindred... Goodness, I hope we can get something going. Something going on here. Juice Robinson versus Kindred for the TTW World Championship. Let me see something really quick. He's got E+ momentum. And Kindred's got, like, F momentum. That really bums me out, dude. I really wanna... What's the high... Because the highest is, like, D+. Oh my god, Cage. Jesus. Part of me wants to just fucking strap the Rocket to Cage. He'll have fucking C- momentum. He'll be the most successful superstar ever made. Even Adam Cole doesn't have a fucking D+. What happened? I guess Cage got the pin, I assume, in that other match. Is that a thing? Can I look at that? Huh? No? Not in this screen? Okay. Let's just book this match first. So, fuck. I don't want to sacrifice Juice Robinson's momentum. Can I give him, like, a screwy, like, a screw job, not a screw job finish, literally, but, like, Truth Martini fucks it up? Will that, like, maintain his momentum? I sure hope so. Let's see how this works. We're gonna go Kindred. We're gonna go Juice Robinson being kept strong. We're going to do open match? Yeah, let's do open match. Tainted legal weapon or outside. Yeah, let's do tainted win with a manager. Do we want the... let me see. Should include... Yeah, I think we definitely want that. And the interference will be... apparently, I'm just not around here. Here we go. Truth Martini. That's better. So if we do some shit like that, where he hits him with the Book of Truth, and, I like to think he hits him so hard with the Book of Truth, he just starts fucking gushing blood. That's what I like to think. I mean, we're not under any sort of cable company to tell us not to do that, so I'd like to think that's what happens. But, yeah, let's just do that for now. So that's good. That's a good thing. So let's just hope that we can maintain some of Juice's momentum as well as promoting Kindred a little bit, because that F momentum is just fucking killing me, dude. Let's run a promo for Veda Scott and Kafu. Let's do that, shall we? Let's see, debut... No, it's not debut client. Well, I mean, you could do that. A manager introduces his or her new client. You could say, oh, like... I mean, obviously it's not a debut, but it's a new client. I mean, yeah? Eh? I don't know. Warren workers, one of the most basic... manager and their clients. Nope. Challenge accepted. Challenge. No. Manager has plan. No. Hypes. Hypes worker? No. Interview. What the fuck? Oh. So, okay, manager hype. Player one's the manager, interviewer. Somebody interviews the manager, and, okay. So I guess this would be Veda, Kevin Kelly, Kafu, and some person Kafu doesn't like? Eh? Is that one? I guess so. Not overness, I'll tell you that much. Issues a promotion warning. A manager lets it known that they intend to dominate the promotion they work. That's fine. I mean, what? Do I want Kafu to be involved in the thing? Offer services. Manager offer services, it's accepted. No, I'd rather her just show up and they're just, like, together. He could cut a promo with her and be like, hey, you know, she wanted to join me, or... I don't know, are they fucking? I don't know what's going on yet. We gotta work this out. Orders beat down. Reveal signing. Self-promotion. No. Menace. Talks to client. Oh my god. Two managers argue. Warns a tag team. Warns another worker. How about warns another worker? Gives an interview where they promise to make life miserable for a worker off-screen. That could work. So she could cut a promo about... Wait, a manager gives an interview where they promise to make... So that would be Veda cutting a promo on Johnny Cockstrong. I don't really like that, because then Kafu's not anywhere there. Then she's just randomly his manager, and then... I feel like he should be there. That's all I'm saying. Should we do Menace? I don't think he's very menacing. He should be. I mean, he's Kafu, but... Can I... 40 Menace, you know? And then, like, what's Veda's, like... How is she, like, entertaining-wise? Like, do we know? So, overall, she's alright. So, like, it's gonna be a very average... Oh, fuck it. Let's try it. Let's see how it goes. We'll do it for, like, 6 minutes. Veda Scott is Kafu's new manager. What? How did that happen? Yeah. Yeah, and they, you know, she just talks about how he's gonna fucking stomp all over everybody, he just needed, you know, a little boost, blah blah blah. I assume, you know, they're with each other now, you know, they're having sex all the time, you know, part of that, you know, that whole deal. Not quite married yet, they kind of just met each other, you know what I mean? We're not pulling, like, the full deal there, but yeah, you get the idea. Okay, so, I have an idea at one point. I was thinking that perhaps Castle and Creed could, like, hold an open challenge and then have the Bravados come out, but, and, like, accept the challenge and maybe beat them, maybe not. But, oh, I don't know, maybe if it would be better if I just had, like, you know, Kevin Kelly announces that, you know, the new TTW Tag Team Championships will be formed, and the Bravados, you know, a new young upstart team, which, you know, they've been a team for a while, but that's besides the point, versus Castle and Creed, the established names in TTW. But I also like the open challenge idea. So I'm not sure what I want to do, and I don't even know if I want to make the titles tonight. Am I able to do that? Can I make the titles tonight, like, as of the show? So I can do that. I can absolutely do that. Jeez. It doesn't cost money, right? To do tag titles? I don't think so. We could do it tonight. I should see first if they have any chemistry as a team. I mean, no, that's wrong. That's wrong what I'm saying. I should see if they have any chemistry as opponents. Because it would be cool to run, like, a little deal with the Bravados and Castle and Creed. However, I don't know if it's going to click or not. I could run... Let's run a pre-show match. I've never done this before. This is a first in TTW history. I've done this before, just not on TTW. Let's run a pre-show and see if the Bravados click with Castle and Creed. That way. Does that affect the momentum? Even if it's on the pre-show? Anybody? Tell me in the comments. Either way. Even if I do this and I already find out the results and everything, tell me just to remind me. Because I'll come back next week and I'll watch the old video and I'll be like, oh boy, I still didn't learn anything from that, or I don't remember it. So definitely tell me in the comments, because I read the comments. So, yeah. Do pre-show, post-show things affect... momentum? I hope not. In which case, I'd probably want to give the Bravados the win, but we'll see. Yeah, something there. So let's do that. Sorry, hitting the microphone with my finger there. Let's give the Bravados a win in this pre-show match. Pre-show test match. Bravados versus Castle and Creed. We could run like a 10-minute match. Just for basic, get the idea here. So let's have, who's the one that, which of them wasn't like as happy as the other one? I think it was him. I think it was Lance or something. I'm not sure. Let's have him win it. Let's keep... I always keep Nelson Creed strong, just because, fuck it. And we'll do open match. And we'll make him work the crowd. This is just to test and see if it works here. Yeah. Yeah. Have, Castle take the loss. And, yeah. So we'll see how that works. We'll see how that works out, because, yeah, that's a really interesting idea. I'll probably just have Castle and Creed, like, cut a promo or do something passive tonight. What did they do last week? They were in that match. Okay, so, like, we'll just have them cut a promo, and they'll... Yeah, you know what? In fact, you can have it be a whole thing where Castle and Creed are, you know, they come out there, they're like, we're the best tag team here, we got no other tag teams, we're gonna hold... you know, a match for the new TTW Tag Team Championships, and it's going to be an open challenge, because there's nobody back there that's going to be any good to get to us. And then, yeah, And then hopefully, being that the match doesn't blow in the pre-show, we'll do the bravados. So there you go. So I'm going to write this down, because I never, you know, I never remember anything. Bravados in the open challenge tag match. Good stuff, good stuff. Okay. So that should be pretty good. I have high hopes for that. I really hope that works out. What else do we got here? Cage needs to be kept good. He needs to really, really be kept hot. He needs to get that momentum. What I might do, I might end up, I want to give Kindred one or two more shows with the title. How long has he had the title? He had the one, he had, okay. He beat ACH, and then, he beat ACH, won in the rematch, and then had that six-man tag. So he's had it for 2 months. So I'd like to keep it one or two more months, and then I might do a transitional deal, like give it to Juice, and then put it on a Cage. So let's just throw Cage in a quick squash match. Because I got to keep that momentum up. Because can you imagine if he fucking got the title? Like, that would be crazy. He'd have, ridiculous momentum. Look at that, dude. They got, no momentum. Like, those were the top two guys. And Cage, oh my god, he could be, he could be the fucking guy we build the company around at this point. So we might do that. So let's just give Cage, put Brandon Watts on the show, because why not? I don't know, do we want to do that? Yeah, we definitely want to. What is that noise outside? Is it done? Okay. Cage and Brandon Watts will be a quick 5-minute squash. Cage squashes Brandon Watts. You know, I'd say, oh, I feel bad for Brandon Watts, but hey, man, he's getting a paycheck. He's showing up. He's getting his paycheck. Don't worry about it. Get somebody over and are willing to sacrifice dominate for. Yeah. Should I do that? That should work, yeah. What the hell is that noise? I'll be right back, guys. I gotta go figure out what this noise is in my house. Okay. Got that figured out, whatever the hell that was. That was annoying. Alright. Cage is gonna be the victor. And that's basically it. That's basically it. I don't want to do domination just on Brandon Watts because he's got, you know, if he was fighting 17, I'd say yeah, but no, let's just do that. So let's do that. We got 37 minutes. Do we want Kafu in a match? I want Marcus Owens in a match because I ran a little hype video last week. Marcus Owens, what are you doing? You're an upper mid-carder. Could fight Happy Meal. Did they fight last week? I forgot if they fought. Happy Meal defeated 7. No. Happy Meal. Marcus Owens defeated Happy. Just fucking ran him over. That got an F+. Happy Meal defeated 17. What are their, what's their momentum like? Happy Meal's got an E-, and Marcus Owens has got an E-. Eh, that's kind of difficult. That's bravado. Marcus Crane. It's face versus face, but I don't... Is that, a big deal? Is that, a big thing? Will I get, super deducted points if I do two faces? I don't want Kafu to lose, straight up. But... That's a hard one. That's a hard one. I guess he could run over... No, I don't want to run over 17. Damn, I am running out of heals. What the fuck? All my heels are main event status right now. Oh, jeez. Adam Cole, he could have like a fucking barn burner with Adam Cole. I'd have to give Adam Cole the win. Yeah, let's do that. Let's just see how that works. Because I kind of like the idea. I feel like they could have a good match. I could be completely wrong, but I didn't get as far as I am, you know, fucking $6,000 profit or whatever I am by not taking risks, right? Huh? Alright. Let's do 15 minutes. We'll do them two, and yeah, let's give Adam Cole the win, but let's keep Marcus Owens strong. They're gonna have a great fucking match. They're gonna have a spectacular, spectacular match. It'll be a pinfall. I'm not gonna say anything like that. We'll just do that. So that's like a solid semi-main. Solid semi-main event. We need 20 minutes. We need... Yeah, fans are expecting to show 70 matches currently. So should we have more promos? Is that what they're telling me? Could do more promos. Let's do one more 2-Dope promo about the Insane Clown Posse. Yo, what was that skit? The Summoning? The fuck was that? Oh my god. Jesus. He summons Violent J. Like, whoa, dude, what the fuck? No. No, he doesn't. Okay, so, arrested? Police officers, that means you would have to hire a bunch of fucking geeks to be, oh no, wait a minute. Player one comes out with police officers to tell a worker. Player two, that he's about to be arrested, only for the police officers to be, oh! Ha! Good one. Good one. That's a good angle. I like that. Roundtable discussion. Why is that a thing? That's terrible. Raw roulette. Proving. Oh no. Proven innocent by tape. Proven innocent by wit. No. Mocking. No. Hanging out with the band. No. The Insane Clown Posse take over the production truck. Like, what the fuck? We don't even have a production truck, man. We're too small of a company. Oh, fuck. Alright, let's just do, okay, I have an idea. This isn't gonna be groundbreaking or anything, but, you know, it'll be alright. Tag team... Let's see, tag arrives, tag confrontation... backstage, carried away, and a breakup of... Yeah, so what we want to do is... Okay, so what we want to do here is not necessarily that 2-Dope wants to be a single star. Actually, we could do it the other way. Okay, so let's do this. So it'll be about 4 minutes, and we'll do five, just... for the fuck of it. So, Marcus Crane approaches 2-Dope backstage, and he's like, hey man, you know, I think it's cool that we're like trying to be a team and like hanging out and stuff, but officially, I don't really want to be like a team. You know what I mean? Like, I just kind of want to do my own thing. And 2-Dope's like, that's fine, dude. I've been trying to fucking join the Insane Clown Posse for the past like 3 months. So, that's fine with me. He says, next show, I'm gonna go fucking find them, and they're gonna show up. I don't care. Marcus is like, whatever, dude. Like, you do what you gotta do, but I'm gonna be doing my own thing, okay? And he's like, fine. So, Marcus and 2-Dope split up. And more or less. They're still friendly. It's just, they're not an official team anymore. So, that's fine. Nothing too crazy. With Veda Scott being the manager of Kafu, let's give him a win over, Johnny Cockstrong, I suppose? Yeah, it doesn't matter. They're both in the shits right now. 8 minutes? 9 minutes? Let's give him 9 minutes. And we'll do Apollo. And, let's just do that. Let's just see if, see how this works. Yeah. 4 more minutes. Anybody want to think of a new promo for me to do? No? Alright. Let me think about this. This is going to be a poorly rated fucking show, by the way. Unless Adam Cole and Marcus Owens just, like, lights up the fucking building, this is going to be a pretty bad show. But, who don't we have used? ACH, Happy Meal. Actually, that could work, to be honest. ACH and Happy Meal. ACH's momentum is already down. So, for example, if I gave Happy Meal, like, a roll-up win, is that bad? Can I do that? Is that going to damage ACH beyond repair? Happy Meal is a fucking... Is he a main eventer? Upper mid-carder. Let's try it. Let's do a... ten-minute match? Let's do a 10-minute match. And ACH is just going to dominate most of the match, but Happy Meal is going to get a quick roll-up victory. ACH is going to be mortified. He's going to be like, oh god. I'm going to try scripting it and see what happens. Because it needs to be a flash pinfall. It could be dirty as well. Illegal weapon, no. No. Isn't there, like, I'm trying to think, like, he rolls him up, like, with the tights or something. Like, rolls him up with tights or uses the ropes. Something along those lines. Tainted win, cheap win, count out or DQ victory. Oh, shit. Loser gets beaten. He has an excuse for the loss as opponent cheated to win. Should not be a clean one. So this is more indecisive, and this is more he cheated. Right? Let's try that. That's two tainted finishes. I don't know if that's going to work, but we'll see. We'll try this out here. So this is going to be a very interesting show. I'm intrigued to see what happens here. Yeah, I know. I know there's a lot of matches. Calm down, everybody. Everybody just calm down. You will not be broken by watching so much fucking wrestling matches, okay? Alright, guys. So let's do this. TTW balls to the wall. Let's fucking run. Wait, did I mess anything up? No? Alright. That gag will run out eventually, I promise. Let's go. 65 people. Pretty average. Awful match. Completely devoid of heat. Bravados defeated Castle and Crete in 10 minutes. With a gentleman's agreement. They did decently in the gimmicks. And it lifted the crowd. So, they don't not click. And they got an E-, which is not too bad. So, that's not the worst. Not engaging the crowd. Why are you not engaging the crowd? Huh. Booking for length, really. How long do you want the match to go? Was it too long? I don't know. So, not too bad, not too bad. Match lifted the crowd. Cage beats Brandon Watts with Weapon X. Gotta keep Cage's deal going. Got an E, not too bad. Pretty good. Veda Scott. Talking to Kafu. His menace must be decent, because, I mean, they got an E out of it, you know? As long as it doesn't get, like, an F, that's all I care about. Veda did good. Beam plus, cool. Okay. Veda did some good work at ringside. And they both improved. This is not bad. This is going a lot better than I thought. I gotta admit. This is pretty good show so far. E. They have good chemistry. Okay, see? That's... This is good. This is great. We're gonna run something from this. We're gonna do ACH and Happy Meal. We're gonna have a feud. We're building up the future here. I was very unsure when I started this episode, but now I'm feeling a lot better. ACH versus Happy Meal. Writing things down. Pen to paper. You know how it is. So that's great. That's really good news. Ooh. That's fine. So, TEW is going to try to go find his Juggalo brethren, and we're gonna see how that goes. Marcus Owens got gassed. What the fuck? The fuck, Marcus Owens? You really needed to pull your fucking weight. You know, you needed to carry your half of the fucking match, and you let it down, man. Adam Cole carried you to that fucking E, dude. Wow. Alright, well, you better get your shit together. Any reason why he was, like, so fucked up? Low locker room morale. He's just gassed, inconsistent. So, I mean, it doesn't seem like it was too much, like, it doesn't seem like he was a dick and just no-sold or something. It just seems like he's just kind of... He just had an off day. Alright, I understand. Adam Cole, even though he wasn't motivated or whatever, he put his part in. He put his effort in. I appreciate that. Holy shit. Guys, this is fucking bad, dude. It's clear to me. It is clear to me Kindred needs to be rid of this fucking title, dude. This is garbage. Good crowd and terrible fucking wrestling. Kindred defeated Juice Robinson in 15 minutes with a torture rack after Truth Martini fucking hit him in the head with a fucking book of truth. Oh, you guys, that's so bad. Okay, seemed off his game, got tired. Why is everybody tired? It's a 15-minute match! Work a match! Have you ever worked a match in your life? You can't go 15 fucking minutes? Come on! Good God. Truth Martini did good work. Lack of flow. What did I book? That's not my fault. Who the fuck booked the fucking Apollo booking the match? Juice Robinson's approving. Oh, dude. Kindred is just fucking bad, dude. I don't know what his fucking problem is. Negative crowd reaction. Poor selling. Oh. Homie, you gotta get your shit together. Wait. It lowered the crowd's mood, but it lifted the crowd? What? Hello? Yeah, this is bad. You can't... You know, I could keep Kindred and, like, keep him around, but... This main event status, that F+, this is not working. That's going to have to... Wow! They expected more angles. Wow. I'm really shocked. I didn't think that was going to be that big of a deal. Wow. I mean, it's okay, because we need to be at an F+, like, in the region, but... Oh, man, that's just disappointing. I mean, look at those ratings. You got E-, two E's, another E-, another E. It was just that main event that fucking killed everything, and I guess people wanted more talking. But, you know, fuck. Fuck me for having so many matches, huh? Oh, wow. Okay, this was a learning experience. I'm not too bummed about it, though. I mean, now I learn. Now I learn what's going on. So... Let's give Veda Scott, let's give her some props. She did well. Let's do, I like Adam Cole for showing up and getting his work done, you know what I'm saying? Give him a hug. And, ACH, Happy Meal. I kind of wanted to give it to both ACH and Happy Meal, because I did not expect that match to be as good as it was. Let's give Happy Meal some love, you know what I'm saying? Let's give him some love. Give him a hug, too. Yeah. God, I should shit on Kindred. I should tell him to fucking shape up or get the fuck out of here. But no, man. No. I like to run a clean, happy business. That's what I like to run, so... Veda's pleased, Cole's pleased, Happy Meal's pleased, everybody's fucking happy. That was a very big learning experience. That was a much more of a roller coaster than I expected out of this show, out of this whole episode. That was crazy. So, wow. Alright. Now we know. That this game is a learning experience in and of its own. And, yeah. Whew, Kindred. My boy Kindred, I'm thinking that's the last show of him as champion. That's what I'm thinking. Jeff Jarrett was apparently not doing too well. The fuck was he doing? He's raring to go. He'd been working through the pain barrier with... Oh, so he was just banged up, but he's alright now. Anybody else doing anything fancy? Oh, Gregory Helms went to NXT. Chubby Gregory Helms, I guess. He's not chubby. Maybe he's just really muscular at that point. I don't know. Anything else? Oh, nothing. Oh, Sabu. Sabu's retiring. Well, that happens. Yep. All right. Zack Sabre will be signing to PWG. That's cool. Okay. Fair enough. So let's save that. And then I guess... Hey, our momentum's going up. As I recall, that was both an F minus, wasn't it? Was it not? I don't know. Let's see. So we got one more week, theoretically, right? To go to the next month. Right? Is that right? Hello? Anybody? Yeah. Yeah, we got one more week. So let's run... Let me run to Monday really quick, and then we'll go back to the next month, and then we'll go get the money and go see what the hell's going on. Alright, we're here to Monday. I want to see this Ring of Honor show real quick. Matt Sydal defeating Nick Jackson. This game really likes to split up the Young Bucks. Not split them up, but like put them in singles matches all the time. I don't know what the hell that's about. What the fuck? Did Matt Jackson win the Ring of Honor world title? Retain it? What the hell is with this game, man? That's so crazy. What the fuck? Okay. Addiction, yeah. Alright. Alright. Cool, cool, cool. Cool stuff. So, nothing new to report here. Does everybody seem happy? Is everybody cool where they're at? He's pleased. Happy. He's happy. Because he got a win, I assume. Yep. Very happy. Kafu. F minus still, damn. Okay. Oh yeah, Lance Bravado's happy. And Veda Scott's pleased. Cool. Shimony. Gregory and dating Garo Loco. Okay. Alright. So, all in all, things are going pretty well. This is good. Yeah. Let's go to next Monday. And we can go see, you know, get the last roundup of the money and everything. And, yeah. Alright, guys, we're here on the first Monday of December 2015. I got some emails, but no. I like to do my favorite part of the whole deal is the WWE pay-per-view that apparently only runs on the third week of any month, so that's something. All eyes on Ricochet, why is that? Dragon Gate are preparing a big push for him that will either make or break him. Wow. Wow. Well, good luck for that, you big-headed, egotistical fuck. Alright. So let's see what happened on Survivor Series. John Cena, the star of the show. What a fucking surprise. I really didn't see that coming. 5.61 buy rate, dude. The buy rates are so, like, overinflated in this game. Like, it's ridiculous. Overinflated? Is that redundant? I don't know. Kingston and The Miz defeated Bryan and Barrett. What a main event. I guess that's supposed to... Well, no, you can book a Survivor Series match in this game. What the fuck? That's so bizarre. John Cena in The Big Show. Hulk Hogan telling John Cena, hey, brother, you know, hey, don't say racist things, brother, or else you'll end up like me. And then he's like, oh, shit, I don't want to end up like you. Ryback defeated Titus O'Neil to maintain... That's not the term. Retain the Intercontinental title. Sting and Seth Rollins, you know, at a bar somewhere, as I usually like to assume they're doing. Henry and Rusev, apparently a tag team, defeated Gold and Stardust. Retain it. Wow. Okay. Henry and Rusev, man, that's not a bad team. Not a bad team. Alicia Fox lost to Nikki Bella because fuck you. That's why. Sandow defeated a bunch of fucking jobbers. Apparently, yeah. Yep. Swagger and Harper, Cameron and Paige, Sami Zayn defeated Tyler Breeze, Daniel Bryan, Brock Lesnar, and Bray Wyatt, no doubt, at a bar, having a few drinks. The Ascension defeated Los Matadores. Vince McMahon, probably doing some perverted shit to Brie Bella to open up the fucking show. Do you guys remember? I don't know, like, you know, like the age of my viewers or the knowledge of wrestling. You have to know a pretty decent amount of knowledge. Do you remember those old fucking skits where, like, Vince McMahon is, like, fucking... He's practically fucking, like, Trish and Stacy and Tori and, like, everyone. Like, literally. Like, that's probably what he was doing to Brie Bella right there. He was probably fucking feeling Brie Bella up for no reason. And Brie's just like, oh, yeah, this is totally normal. I'm willing to do this. Yeah, this is great. Brad Maddox defeated Solomon Crowe because Solomon Crowe can't catch a break in real life or in the video game. Sin Cara 2 defeated Bold MC. What a show. What a very mediocre show that turned out to be. What would have been the match of the show? Fucking Big Show and John Cena? Oh, Sting and Seth Rollins was a brawl. I'm sorry. They're not drinking. They could have been drinking. They could have been brawling at a bar. Who knows? Made more money. That'll work, dude. Okay, so I lost a few dollars in terms of signing the Bravados and Veda Scott. That's fine. I'm totally willing to do that. And if I can keep it up, I'd like to sign the Insane Clown Posse, but it's not looking super promising right now. What did we get here? Workers. So, 96.50 last month. How is that? Oh, no, wait, I'm sorry. This is, like, way over here. 67.50 to 59.70. Okay, so, that, okay. Merchandise. That's so funny. We sell, like, a shit ton 1 month, and then we sell, like, nothing another month. That's really bizarre. Okay. So, I think I still might want to wait on the Insane Clown Posse, because they're just too fucking much. Too much. Did I remove the Bravados yet? No. Move the Bravados. Thank you. Okay. Alright, well, that'll do it for this episode, guys. Thank you for sticking around, watching the show, and, yeah, we'll talk to you guys later.